think we are ready to do this thing. So, guitarist, I guess the first question is, are you ready to do this thing? And give me an A-OK if you're ready. Guitarist, I need to see some A-OKs. Okay, I think we got A-OKs all around. And parents, grandparents, friends, and family, everybody ready? Thank you for being so patient. I know it's a lot of waiting, but hey, I think we're being pretty efficient here. It's been a big day already. We've been here since 11. Got my great helpers. I just want to give a big round of applause first off to. So we got Ileana, Parker, Zuri, Indy, and Elizabeth. And on sound, Hannibal, let's give them some applause right now. They've been working hard. Yeah, putting these concerts on takes a lot of time and effort and a lot of people. And I really appreciate all of you showing up on a Saturday to watch the musicality of all these fantastic guitarists. And I'm going to get things started with my good friend Farrell here. And one thing that I think is pretty excited about, exciting for me about Farrell playing, excuse me one second. So Farrell and I and his brother Uba, we all share birthdays this month, which is kind of exciting. And Farrell's just about to turn 6, and he's the proud owner of an 1/8-size guitar. I don't know how many of you have seen this, but I only found these, sourced these in the last year, which is exciting for me because I also started doing Suzuki training the last year. I've been teaching for 24 years now, and it's always fun after doing something for a long time to get more breadth in one's approach. So that's been really fun to get some different perspective. And what we're going to play is the very first song in the Suzuki approach, which is Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. But we've got a little different take on it here, so I think you'll enjoy this. And then we're going to get Farrell's brother Uba on stage after this. What a way to start the concert. And so Farrell's going to head back and hang out with his mom and dad. And everybody, that was fantastic. Applause for such a fantastic performance. And guitarists, remember the way you can say thank you for the audience appreciating your music is to take a bow. That's the way we can say back as performers, thank you. I'm going to get Uba, Farrell's brother, up here, and his classmates Emma and Ellis, and we're going to go on this side. And I think you are all... Let's have you sit right there. And let's see, Emma's got her book. So we'll have... You can use this book. And Emma right here. Ellis right there. And I'll give you... The first one is called Wind in the Willows, and the second one is called Water Starter in Hannibal. This is one where we're doing the pizzicato sound, so it's pretty quiet. And the guitarist, we're going to get way up. When we play that one, you can sit where you're at now, but when we play our pizzicato, let's get really close to the microphone. And if you don't know what pizzicato is, well, you'll know soon enough. Not quite yet, though. Only when we do the pizzicato, you can sit where you're at now. All right, are we ready for this thing? Am I ready? Oh. Yeah. So we got teams here. I'm going to be on the team with Ellis because these are both duets, and that's a lot of fun for me with the kids to practice music with parts and really get to learn about playing parts together. All right, are we ready for this thing? That first song was called Wind in the Willows, and the second one was called Water Strider, and that was, I think, achieved the goal of sounding somewhat insect-like. And that pizzicato technique is where you mute the strings while you're playing. Well, I'm going to bring Philip up to the stage, and he's upstaging me. I don't have a good cowboy hat, but this guy, he seems to do this every time. Philip comes to these concerts just looking stylish. I feel a little underdressed. We're going to play another piece of music from this book, and this is in the second level. So for those of you that know, and those that you don't know, the book is in levels, and you have to master all the songs in each level to move on. This one's called Saddle Up and Mosey On, hence Philip's awesome gear here. So these two are going to do a duet for us. And this was their last song they learned before graduating into note reading. So they learned this one not too far back. It's called the arpeggio song. And listen for them. They're going to trade a bass part and an arpeggio part. So see when you can notice when they trade. Thank you. Awesome, playing you two. All right, so I'm excited about this next one. We have a mother-daughter duo and, well, trio. I get to play two, lucky me. And these two, Amanda and her daughter Olivia, have been at it for a while here. And I love it when parents are learning guitar alongside their children. It's a lot of fun. We're going to do a trio. Let's have Olivia right here. And we're going to do a very cheerful piece of music for you. I hope you're ready to have some sunshine. This one's called Sunshine Strut. And it's a little bit of 50s kind of bop happiness. And I think we got a pretty awesome trio going. Filled with 50s music, so that kind of it distilled into my soul. So when I wrote this one, it was a little bit of a nod to that part of my childhood. Once again, outdressed. I love that. The purple is perfect. The only thing Olivia could have done more was to have a poodle skirt. I should have said something with that. Well, John's going to come up and join me here. So John is going to play with me a piece of music called Grasshopper Stomp. And this is kind of modeled after that old story about the grasshopper and the ant. Grasshopper just hung out all summer long playing his guitar. And this is the song that he would play. And by the way, you'll see John's sister Lola coming up before too long. Thank you. Aiden is coming up on stage with me here. We'll send a nod to, come on this way, Aiden. Come on this way. Send a nod to his classmate Cal, who couldn't make it today. I'll try my best to sit in for Cal. He plays pretty awesome. And we have a salsa piece of music for you here called Dance of the Jalapeno Popper. And feel free to get up and dance if you're a salsa dancer. I keep trying to tell these guys in his class, go ahead and use the foot stool, that once they master a song or perform it, once they master the song or perform it, they have to eat a jalapeno popper. You gonna do it, Aiden? No. Okay. Love it, the stylish costuming here. So, so Milana and Karina, who are cousins, are going to play us a song that you may or may not recognize that's got a little bit of a cowgirl theme to it. I'm kind of curious to see who does recognize it. Well, maybe we won't say what song it is right away. We'll let people see if they recognize it. This is an instrumental version of a song that has lyrics. And it's been so much fun having these girls in class together. They just play together so beautifully. Thank you. awesome. You two. I wasn't sure if they'd do the hats. I'm so glad they did. That just gives it that much more festive quality to it. Who recognized the song? If you didn't, that's Old Town Rose Old Town Road. Lil Nas X and Billy Ray Cyrus, right? A country singer and a rap singer. They teamed up on that one, and we played it as a guitar instrumental. It's a wild world. All right, coming up, we've got quite a crew. We're going to have Winona is joining with Hannah and Willa and Nico. Right there. Normally, she's in a different class, but her classmate couldn't make it, so we thought for this song, it would be pretty awesome to have a big crew. We are going to be doing the pillow battle. So this is kind of an intense one. The Mugglywumps and the Picadillos march to the pillow battle, and then the battle begins. So if you haven't heard this one, I think it's kind of exciting. And so picture these opposing armies, their war pillows slung over their shoulders as they march to the pillow battlegrounds. And then I think you'll hear where the battle truly begins. Let me get a little mic set up here, and we'll start it. One fun thing for me is these kids are all just such good musicians. Nico and Winona have been in class. Nico had to move to join this group because of sports. And then Winona is now jumping in with this group to play a concert. They're all such good musicians, they can do that. They're so good at listening to each other and jumping in with musicians they haven't even played with. Are you ready to do battle? Okay, here comes the march. I'm going to get out of the way here, and Finley is going to get up on stage. And Finley, we'll have you sit in this position over here. So one more chair over here. And Hannibal, I'm going to have her sit in the third position here. And she's going to play a solo, which... Finley, is this the first solo you've done? Which, everybody give her a hand for getting up on stage solo. That takes a lot of guts. This is her first time playing solo in one of these concerts, and she's going to play kind of two things back to back, Prepare for Blast Off and Blast Off. nicely played. Well, I love it when we have these fantastic guitars where I get to sit back and just enjoy. We're going to have another soloist come up. So Adri is going to take center stage here. Beautiful playing, Adri. Really nice. So we're going to bring Lola up on stage. You got to hear her brother John and I play a duet earlier, and she's got a solo for us here. And this is one that came out of the Suzuki material that I've been studying with, and it's a really beautiful waltz. So I will let her take this waltz away. Just notice, though, this is kind of a fun challenge. There's three parts. There's a bass part, a melody, and then there's an internal chord part. So she's juggling three balls here with this song. Thank you. Very nice. Well, it's really fun for me to have more soloists getting. Let's have you one chair over there. More soloists getting up on stage and really showing us their skills. I love to play duets and play with the groups, but it's really nice to just be able to listen from the other side to these really skilled guitarists. So, Kyla is going to play us a piece of music called Calliope, although it's become the fashion to pronounce it Calliope. Sounds much more mysterious. So, Kyla's going to play us Calliope, which was modeled after music like we hear at the Carousel of Missoula. Beautiful playing. You can see the carousel, the ponies going up and down. So we're going to bring Sean's classmate, or Kyla's classmate, Sean, up on stage here. And Sean is, I hadn't even connected. Sean's going to play a song by another Sean, Sean Mendez. And this is a fun pop song, Stitches, which... we've talked about the lyrics. They're kind of brutal, so I prefer the instrumental version. I don't know who's heard this song before. You've probably run it across it playing on the radio or at the gym, but take it away, Sean. Thank you. Sean. That was solid. All right, so who recognized that one? Anybody? All right, we got some hands up. Really nicely done. So, Elliot, come on over. And we'll send some kind thoughts to Elliot's dad. He injured himself today, but Elliot's still able to be here. Go ahead. And Elliot's going to take us from very modern music, pop song, to the Renaissance. And he's got a couple Renaissance songs back to back for us, Green Sleeves and Palace of Nonesuch. Awesome playing, Elliot. I love music from that period on guitar. The guitar wasn't an instrument at the time, but it works so well. Beautifully played. Well, our crew boss, Ileana, is getting up on stage. She's been helping head up the tuning committee over here. We're going to take it back to the present from the Renaissance, and she's got a piece of music by Imagine Dragons for us here. So Radioactive by Imagine Dragons. Disrupt such an awesome performance where she's playing so powerfully that the mic is being overloaded. So I'm going to actually have you scoot back a little bit. We couldn't even fix it on the mixing board side. You know, part of what it is, when was this guitar built?
Oh my goodness, like early 1910s.
Yeah, so this guitar is amazing. It's over 100 years old and it's got that much power to it. I'm going to give a, holy cow, we got to back off the power of the microphone. So let's give us just a little check here first.
Play a little bit of the middle part or something.
It's just so amazing that this guitar could be that old and be as powerful as it is.
Okay. Sound good?
Redo. Thank you, everybody, for your patience.
Okay, from the top? Okay. The wonderful curse of having a nice guitar. Okay. Got this.
And you may have noticed she was doing some pretty fancy stuff there with adding percussion to the playing. We're going to get Jeremy and Matthew up on stage. And these guys were willing to team up together. Normally they've been playing this song separately, but I think we're going to make a pretty awesome trio and play you a Beatles song, Blackbird, and just a teaser. The song is going to end with another Beatles song. So a little bit of a Beatles theme today. And we'll get these guys set up. After this, you're going to hear from Jeremy's brother, Jonathan. And it's really fun for me to have siblings in class and just see how similar they are growing up in the same family, but how different they are, and even how different they play with their guitar playing. All right, so Jonathan's got a solo for us. We heard Lola play this. He's going to do his interpretation of the waltz by B. Kalatayud. That's the name of the composer, and I'm excited to hear it. Now, by the way, I've known this guy since he was about... Okay. Well, we have Audrey and her sister Nora coming up, and these two are also going to give us... They're going to give us their interpretation of Water Strider, the insect song we heard a little bit earlier. And again, it's so fun to have siblings playing together. So these two... See, how long, Audrey, was it before Nora started that you started guitar? Was that at least 2 years? And then it's been a little over a year that Nora's been in guitar as well. And so we're going to follow this up with Audrey's lesson partner, Paige, will come join us. Paige up on stage. And we heard Adri play this song solo earlier. It's fun to hear it as a duet as well. So this is the song Snow Flight that we heard. And excuse me a second here. Paige and Audrey are a lot of fun to have in class. They just play together so beautifully and listen so well to each other. We played a lot of duets. They're going to play the song Snowflake for us once I get the microphone set. Beautiful. So Russell's coming up on stage, and we've got a little bit of a pop theme going today. He's going to give us another song from a more modern repertoire, and I kind of like just leaving it in leaving it to people to see if they can guess what song it is. Okay, and before I say what it was, anybody know? We had some boomers that know. So that was a Red Hot Chili Peppers song, Under the Bridge, beautifully rendered by Russell there. Well, we have a very exciting duet for you here. These guys, Caden and Bridger, who are just so fun to have together in class, they are going to play us a samba-inspired piece of music, Marchinha de Carnaval. Has anybody here ever been to the carnival in Brazil? I certainly haven't. Did I see any hands go up? Maybe someday. So I have friends have gone. I've watched video. It looks incredibly exciting. The music is very, very exciting. So they're going to try to bring us some of that Brazilian party music, really. So you guys ready to take us to Brazil? Let's get way closer. All right. Thank you. That I felt like I was in Brazil. That is fun music. Well, we are going to get Lola and Avery up on stage. These two are sisters and play together like only sisters can. I love having these two in class together, and really fun when we get to work on different duets. And they have another very familiar tune here by Coldplay, Viva La Vida. And it's only recently that I had some people request to do this as a duet. Generally, it's been a trio or quartet version that we've done. But I think it was it Davis and Gus? I think they were the first ones to think of the idea. And then these two are actually the first to perform it, because those guys aren't till the next concert. Thank you. That was so awesome. Very nice. We are down to our last couple of performances. I'll have you over here, Weston. And so Weston's going to play a part of a piece of music he's been working on for a while. He's given us, this is one that you kind of have to have in installments. It's so good. And then we'll be wrapping things right up. We've got one more duet after Weston. And he and I are going to play, after he plays part of this piece, Tango de Lejo, we're going to play a Brazilian bossa nova, Black Orpheus, for you here. Well, we are almost to the end of our concert here. Thank you so much for coming out on this Saturday and supporting all these fine musicians. And I know for me, it's just so lovely to see the different levels of skill and ability. And I'm sure a lot of you get to see the same students from concert to concert and see where they go with their music. So we're going to play this samba or the bossa nova piece, and then we've got a grand finale. I'll wait to tell you what it is. And then after that, if everybody could come up here, we'll make a line, guitarists who can come up, and we'll hand you your guitar. But we won't crowd too much because we have our helpers to get your guitar and then get your case in there. And then we're going to have another crowd in here momentarily. So we probably need to head out fairly quickly. The concert, this was a jam-packed concert. So thank you again for coming out. Thank you, guitarists. Let's give one round of applause for all these guitarists. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, so pretty hard to top that improvising there. He was just playing that off the top of his head, some fantastic jazz playing. But we've got a very different duo here for our finale. And this is Rowan and her father, Patrick. And they have a beautiful song that Rowan has been working on singing and playing, which is really fun. There's not too many students have gotten up on stage and sang along with their guitar playing. And then she's got her dad giving her some accompaniment.
And I think we'll be okay just with the voice coming through the other mic. Yeah. So this will be our finale for the concert. So everybody, come up afterwards, grab your guitars.
Okay, take two. Beautiful playing, you two. Well, I love hearing all these guitarists share their music, so thanks again, guitarists, for coming and being brave, getting up on stage. Thank you, parents and grandparents and family, for supporting. Grab your guitars, and we will see you all next week. Okay, I think we have all our guitarists here. So it has been quite the day. We're in our second concert here today. We started setting up at 11. And I want to just give, first off, a big thank you to all the helpers. So Hannibal Hayes is helping us with the sound, which is a big job. These guitars are kind of quiet, so it's really helpful to have microphones to fill the space. So he's working very hard today. And then we've got our crew. Ileana's heading up the tuning team. We've got Indy and Parker and Elizabeth and Zori. So that has been really helpful. They've been working hard today. So thank all of you for showing up today, too. Well, let's give them a round of applause first. And a big thank you to Parker's mom for the tacos. Those were very nice. Okay, so we have quite a concert for you, and you kind of all lucked out. It ended up through circumstance that the first concert was a lot longer than this concert. So we got a little room to breathe on this one. And we have a whole variety. We've got multiple parents joining in. It's going to be quite a show. There's some premieres at this. There's some new versions of songs you might have heard before, some excellent teams of students, and a couple things first. Does everybody have their phone in airplane mode or don't bother me mode? You're welcome to take video, welcome to take photos. We're taking a lot of photos. I'll send out a link to those. We're live right now. We've got people watching on YouTube. Anybody here know somebody that's watching the live stream? We've got a few. Great. So it is going to be quite a show, and I think we should get it kicked off. Couple things for students. I'm going to invite our first performer up, so come on up here. So Brooks and I are going to be the first performance of the day. And so students, a lot of you have done this before. This is Brooks' first concert, so I think we should give him a hand for getting on stage here. And we're going to have him sit over here. So he's never experienced what you do with a guitar at a guitar concert. So I want everyone to just notice this. These microphones are sensitive, but we need to get pretty close to them to really have it work well. So we want to make sure, just like Brooks is doing when we scoot up, we'll be just close to it, and you can get in your best position. You will be just fine right there. I'm going to drop it down a little bit. So we want to be close to the microphones. You're good there. And when we play, of course, people are going to be so inspired. They'll be applauding wildly. And then after we play our song and they're applauding wildly, we can take a bow, Brooks, to show them that we appreciate them listening right after our song. And I think that's all. You ready to play?
Premiere at a Garden City Guitar Program concert. This is a song called Billy Goat. And if you know the notes on the guitar, you might notice there's some alliteration going on with the words and the notes that we're playing.
So that was Brooks' first concert, and also, he's actually only been playing guitar for about a month, so that was quite brave to get up on stage here. Well, we have another guy who's pretty new to guitar. Not that new. You've been playing for a little bit, but this is his second concert. So he's getting to be quite the pro here. And we've got something I think is pretty exciting. Now, some of you know I started doing, I've been playing, teaching guitar for 24 years now. But just a year ago, I started training in a little different approach called Suzuki. And there are teaching approaches for with Suzuki for lots of instruments. But one of the really big deals, for, many of you might know this, the first song you do in the Suzuki approach is Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. But not just the regular one. So you'll hear, this is a special version of Twinkle, Twinkle. Quite a Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star journey, wasn't it? And just in case you don't know, the lyrics are Mississippi hot dog for the first one, peanuts and popcorn for the second, and then run pony. And you could hear that pony running in the last one. So I have Beckett up on stage with me, and we are going to do a song from the new reading book that I wrote over the last year. And it's been a lot of fun to watch kids go from learning their technique on the guitar and then getting into being confident with note reading as well. I'm going to do a quick tune-up. And actually, I misspoke. Beckett just graduated into note reading. This is the graduation song to get into the note reading book. So we are doing arpeggio song.
Let's have William right here, Malin, third one over. These guys. All right, so we have a fantastic trio coming up here. I'm lucky enough to get to join these guys. And this is actually a premiere, what we're going to do for you today.
And I don't remember how it came about, but we're going to play a song from that new reading book that I talked about and then do something a little different with it here. Something who thought of this idea? I don't remember if it was one of you guys or if I did, but it came about, and this is the first time that we've done it in a performance, and the song is Grasshopper Stomp, which was inspired by the story of the grasshopper and the ant. So there was the very lazy grasshopper, and the ant was working away. The grasshopper was just sitting around playing guitar all summer long. You know the rest of the story, I'm sure. So these guys are playing the parts of the grasshopper, just enjoying the summer, kicking back, playing guitar. And then something else happens here. We'll kind of leave it to surprise.
And this is Chance, Alex, and Kai.
So the grasshopper ended the summer with a bang, with a party playing La Bamba. Okay, let's have you over here, Everett.
Right here, and we'll have her dad right here.
All right, I love it when I get to just get out of the way and watch something really cool.
And we'll want to have you, yeah, okay. We'll want to have you close up on this mic, so maybe scoot that chair back up.
And this is something, we've heard versions of this in concerts before, but not like this version. So I'm sure you'll recognize this one. All right, so Matt and his son Everett are going to play a duet for us here, and then this is going to feature Everett playing some slide guitar, which we don't have a lot of that on these performances. So take it away, guys, or once Everett's ready here.
One, two, ready, go. Wait, 1 second. Yeah. 1 2 ready, go.
That was some serious rock and rolling, guys. Well, we're going to get Paul and Nels up here. Oh, and by the way, guitars, make sure, I'll try to help remind you, but we want to be very, very close to the microphone, so just a few inches away. And Nels, let's have you right here and Paul right here. And this is, I think, a really special premiere that we've got. These guys are going to play two songs that kind of go together thematically. So the first one is actually a composition by Paul and a little bit of a collaboration as Nels came up with his part to go with this. And it's a piece of music called Cowboy Campout. And that's going to be followed by a song from our reading book called We Leave at Dawn. So we thought they kind of went together pretty well, these two songs back to back. So Nels is going to kick it off, right? So wasn't that fun? So the cowboys come into camp with Paul's song, and then they had their night under the stars. Really fun to have kids play songs they've written. So I'm going to get Willa and Violet and Catherine on stage. Just have Willa here, and then Violet, and then Catherine. And this is such a great trio. These kids just play so well together. And I think we've got a pretty fun culture in our class. We are going to play an Irish tune for you here, Irish Washerwoman. Let me get everybody set first.
Thank you.
And let's get Wilder up here too, please. So Jackson, we'll have you right here. So we've got Jackson and Wilder each going to give us a solo, and then they've got a duet. And maybe, Dave, we'll get you set here as well. We're just going to get everybody on stage to make this nice and smooth and easy. So these guys do a kind of fun thing where they have some time separate, and then we have some crossover time together and work on ensemble songs. So they're each going to play one of their solo songs for us and then play a version of Pachelbel's Canon. This is one that I made that's a little different from the original, and I figure probably shouldn't have the same name, so it's called Taco Bell's Canon. And really fun for me to have Jackson's father, Dave, on stage. I get to just sit back and enjoy. He's going to play the trio with them. And so Jackson's going to play a piece of music that I wrote called The Flight of the Roughneck Skrillink. And then you got to hear We Leave at Dawn a minute ago. Well, Wilder's going to play for us We Leave at Dawn 2. So you get a kind of a special back-to-back treat with that. All right, Jackson, take it away. So just that. Thank you. nice, guys. So fun to be able to hear those solo skills and hear the ensemble. They're really playing together. Beautiful. Well, I'm going to invite Eli, Bridge, and Mile up to the stage. And let's have Bridge right here. You and I are the team, right? And then Eli next up and Mile on the end. And this is definitely a first that we're going to do. It's not the first time either of these songs have been played in a concert, but we've got a pretty cool medley we're going to do for you here. I think somewhat surprising. So I won't even say what it is. I think we'll surprise you here. Did you all get which two movies we were referencing there? Harry Potter and Pirates of the Caribbean. They go together pretty well. Maybe that's maybe we're foreshadowing something, a teaming up of these characters. I don't know. So we're going to get a soloist on stage here. This is Keenan.
Let's have him join over, how about right over there.
And we're going to shift from Hollywood to a really powerful classical piece of music. We're following that same key, A minor, moving into another A minor. And this was written by Mauro Giuliani. Who is one of the most important guitar composers.
Just to double check. There was a lot of music written for other instruments in the up to the 17th century, but not a lot of guitar, so through the
So now we've got one of our staff members coming up to the stage. Parker's going to take it from the mid or early 1800s to a little more modern times. We've got a Shawn Mendes song, Stitches, here. Well, we're going to get another one of our staff members up here. So Indy's coming up on stage. Thank you all for being such a great audience. This has been a lot of fun. We still have a few more performers here. One thing I did today, I don't know if you noticed, that's I haven't done for a while, is really put the kids in order of age and experience. So you got to see the brand new guitarists, and it's really fun to see the progression, I think. So Indy and his sister have both been at this for a while. His sister's not able to be here today, but Indy's got a couple of back-to-back solos for us. He's going to do one by Leo Brower, who's a contemporary guitarist and composer, and then follow that up with a really beautiful classical piece by Paganini, Niccolo Paganini. Take it away. What a fun combo of pieces. So great playing, Indy. Well, bringing up to stage one of our longest running veteran players at this point. This is Millie, and she is going to play a piece of music that I wrote. And I was just asking her how many concerts she thinks she's played at. She was thinking definitely at least 15. And she's played with an ensemble and played things aside from our spring and fall concerts, but I'm kind of curious for all these guitarists, because we have some pretty serious veteran guitarists. We already know that some of our guitarists today, it was their first concert or second concert. So raise your hand if you think you've done, well, more than two concerts. And parents can raise their hands too, if you've been to more than two. How about more than four concerts? So that'd be, 2 years of playing. How about six concerts? That'd be like 3 years of playing. And eight concerts, that's around 4 years. All right, and then, of course, there's other things like the Christmas caroling and so on. But just these concerts, 10. Let's see, 10. That'd be like 5 years of playing. And 12, 6 years of playing. So we've got some hands up. And then even more than that, like Millie here and a couple other guitarists. So she's going to play a piece of music that I wrote. This was actually something I wrote for my wedding called The Moment. Beautiful, Millie. All right, thanks, Millie. So I'm going to bring Ethan up to the stage. Well, he's getting set up. So one thing I realized I forgot to ask my helpers to do is to move the Bibles and the pencils and the paper, and I'm seeing a lot of stuff that's happening over at the pencils and the paper. Parents, if you could please help the church is doing such a nice favor for letting us come back here these years. So everybody, please do your best to help us leave this in as good a shape as we found it here, in better shape. So when we get to the end of concert, if you could maybe just check in with your child and make sure the area they're sitting in is nice and clear. And if there's papers that have been drawn on, let's go ahead and take those. And if we can all just look after the space, I would definitely appreciate that. I'm so thankful to St. Paul's to have this. I've had concerts at many, many venues over the years, and this is definitely one of my favorites. So we've got, after that, after a wedding song, we've got a Red Hot Chili Pepper song. I love to have a mix of things, that's for sure. And so Ethan's going to play us Under the Bridge. Nice, Ethan. So I love that percussive playing. That's something Ethan's been exploring more. Ethan and Ileana both have been playing with that. Well, this is something that has really only happened in a couple concerts. So Will had asked about playing electric on this. He's a very excellent acoustic player. And as we've all been learning, electric guitars really, it's the same stuff, but you can definitely get some different sounds. So we are, with this, going to try something a little different. And he brought his amplifier. He's going to play a version of the Rolling Stones song, Paint It Black. So who's played Paint It Black? Raise your hand if you played this one. So we have a few different versions that I like to teach. And what was fun for me about bringing this one in, I mean, a lot of adults especially have heard this, not as many of the kids, but it's got a very intense, almost classical sound that works great on solo guitar as an instrumental as well. Not to mention the Rolling Stones are cool. So Will is, he's doing an exciting first here and playing an electric guitar solo. a little different kind of sound, so let's take it away, Will. Nice, Will. Awesome. So we've just got a few more songs left for you here. And thank you all for being such a patient and supportive audience. So one of our assistants here, Elizabeth, and her classmate Kingston have a duo. We're going to really switch it up after the Rolling Stones and switch it to a little more Afropop here. And this is an arrangement that I did of a song that was a collaboration between a French jazz violinist and a group of Senegalese percussionists and a West African bassist. The violinist Jean-Luc Ponty wrote this and did a collaborative recording with these African musicians and came out with something pretty cool. And I've played this with bigger bands, but I love it on guitar, just having a guitar duo. It's a lot of fun. So it's called Mauna Boa, and we're going to feature Kingston doing a little improv here. So she's going to take a solo in the middle of the song. And let's see, after this, what are we down to? All right, and then we have one more piece of music for you, so take it away, girls. Well, we are down to our last couple of groups. That was beautiful, girls. Really nice. Isn't that a fun piece of music? So, and I do ask everybody to stay until the end of the concert. We just got a couple more performers. And then after that, we'll have everybody, all the students come up and make a line, and we'll get you your guitars. But I want to bring up one of our star helpers here. Our been so great to have these helpers today. And go ahead and sit. Let's have you sit right here, actually. I'm going to have her sit there. Hopefully that helps. Please. And Zori's going to play a solo piece of music by probably my favorite guitar composer, Andrew York. And this is called Snowflight. Hopefully no more snowflights, but I don't know. We may still have some snow. But this song really captures that title. Well, I just told Davis and Gus, no pressure, but you're our finale. So no big deal. You're just the, no. So these guys came up with this idea. I think it was Gus that thought of it. So some of you may have heard some trios and quartets playing Viva La Vida by Coldplay before. But Gus was like, well, Davis and I should do it as a duet, which I didn't think at first it was going to work. There's a lot going on in that song, but these guys have done a really nice job of bringing the song to life with just two guitars. So this will be our last piece, and then guitarists will come up, get guitars, make sure you get your cases, and then parents, if everybody could just help us make the place look nice on your way out. And everybody, thanks for taking the time, supporting all these guitar players. Let's give them one round of applause here just before we're done. And thanks to the helpers, they've had put in a long day to make this work. So Elizabeth, Ileana, Indy, Parker, Zori, Hannibal, thank you very much for being here today. All right, I think we're ready for our last piece of music here. You guys set? One second here, one last adjustment. Thank you. Yeah. Awesome playing. Well, I think we had a pretty good concert there. Some fantastic playing. I just want to say, guitarists, I know it takes a lot of courage to get up here and do this. So good for all of you for doing that, stepping up. Everybody, thank you so much. And come grab a guitar. Enjoy your evening. And I'm sure more to come from all these fantastic young musicians.